Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I'm available for code reviews and on-site training. Now in this episode, I want to give you your second homework assignment. This one is to const all the things. Now, this is just a quick recap. In the previous homework assignment, I told you to auto all of the things. And this can apply to any project of your choosing, something that is new or something that you have been working on for a while. These homework assignments are exercises. They are to teach you more about the language and its limitations in certain contexts. So I suggested that if you did not have a project to work on, that you use this small PT global illumination in 90 lines of C++ project. Now, again, this is not necessarily a best practices kind of an episode. This is a how to learn more about C++ and its limitations kind of episode. And this project, Small PT, is a 99-line C++ project. Now, if you ask Clang Format to reformat it for you, it's more like 149 lines of code. It has many inconsistencies, and it is perhaps not a stellar example of best practices, but it is a tiny self-contained example that you can play with and practice with. So I have the version up here that I had last started messing with in my auto all of the things episode. Now this is const all of the things. And the basic premise is I want you to go through and make every single thing const that can be that is not currently const. No. Let's take this back a moment. Not everything that can be, make it const. I want you to make everything const that is possible to make const. You're going to need to use a series of tools for this. And I'm just going to put a quick note in here as scratch space. One way to help make more things const is with functions. So you might write a quick function that calculates a value and returns that back to you instead of having a branch with an uninitialized value or whatever. So like these guys that are up here, vec, p, e, and c, these should all be const. They can't be const. No, that's a terrible example. These are member variables. I'm going to leave this mistake in here, because we don't want to const member variables. Or, you know what? Go ahead and try to make all of the member variables const. This is not a best practices episode. This is a learning the limitations of the language. Now, if you have to make some things mutable or do const cast, we're never const casting in this experiment here. If you have to use a const cast somewhere, then you have failed the exercise. Never const cast. But prime examples would be like this global spheres object. That should probably just be made const, for example. And parameters that are passed in as values, those can be const. What is this thing taking a pointer? I don't know. Can it be const? Maybe, maybe not. One advantage to using this in Compiler Explorer is that we can try to make it const and see what happens. Here we get a compile time error because we try to mutate it with the erand48 function. And then looking at things like the camera and these vectors, this is all pretty simple code, but a lot of these calculations in here, these things like NC, NT, NNT, whatever they mean, those things can probably be const. And if they aren't currently const, you'll need to figure out how to reorganize the code so that they can become const. That is the point of this exercise. Just remember, if you ever use const cast, then you've gone outside the boundaries of this exercise. And you probably don't want to const the member variables, but you know what? If you find some that you can and you want to experiment with it, then go ahead and experiment with it. Now, like I stated in the last episode, I will have a portion of the official C++ Weekly GitHub if you want to submit your own examples of what the code looked like after you const did all of the things. And you can also start from your version that you autoed all of the things in if you want to. If you like that code, then carry it forward to this const all of the things. Otherwise, start with this from scratch or start with some other project and see what you learn through this exercise. So, thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope you have fun with this one, just like I hope you had fun with the auto.